let's get started. In very simple words, AWS Step Functions allow you to build custom backend workloads called state machines. And these are pure serverless mini services made of smaller modules called states that are glued together by logic rules such as if and else for. This lets you focus solely on ensuring that each state performs its intended task in a very decoupled way, without having to worry about connecting states with others, because AWS Step Functions will handle that for you. So, a state machine acts like an orchestrator that helps in designing and deploying complex workflows. Also, they can be as simple or as complex as you can imagine. They can run up to a year, and this makes them perfect, a perfect solution for large asynchronous services. So when we need to build a workload or have multiple tasks that need orchestration, and that's a huge amount of cases, Step Functions coordinates between those tasks. This makes it simple to build multi-step systems. But you must be wondering why we need to use Step Functions, or why are they so amazing, or why not to use a single Lambda function? Let me tell you. First of all, it's easy to build and deploy. Very easy to build. You can get started with a simple drag and drop interface like called Workflow Studio, or write your own workflow as a JSON object using Amazon States language. Then you can use CDK, SAM, Amplify or AWS console to deploy your state machine to the cloud or higher environments. So using Step Functions, you can express complex business logic as low code. Have an event driven workflows that can connect microservices, systems, people within seconds. Also, you can track the progress of your state machine directly in AWS console. So easily, you can see easily the execution path of your workflow as a dynamic diagram, and finding which of the states maybe are failing or need optimization. Second, you will write less integration code, and that's amazing. So recently, AWS has incorporated more than 200 services. I mean, 200 services, 9,000 APIs that you can integrate into your state machine as direct tasks, direct predefined tasks. So you can just drag and drop them to your state machine, okay? That means that you can query, for instance, you can query DynamoDB table, and with those records, you can invoke a Lambda function, and then you can get a file from S3 based on the Lambda results. And finally, you can hire a satellite or do anything you want with a file from S3, right? So all these without writing a single line of code, just inserting those predefined states in your state machine and setting some parameters. So basically, anything that's available in any AWS SDK library that you surely have seen in your favorite language as Python or JavaScript, that anything that you can do with your AWS SDK library, you will be able to perform the same actions inside a state machine, okay, as predefined tasks. Third, Step Functions are now perfect for any use case. You have standard workflows and express workflows. So standard workflows are awesome for large asynchronous jobs. They can run up to a year, and basically you can just put your large and heavy logic there, and it will and you will see how it performs. And then you have express workflows that support high volume request response event driven services. Those are perfect for short synchronous API calls. You can just create a REST API using these kind of state machines. So you can invoke these express workflows just via API gateway, and they can run for up to 30 seconds as API gateway demands. And this can be our or your great opportunity to get rid of those heavy, complex Lambda functions that and replace them with elegant, smaller pieces of logic that are orchestrated by a state machine. Think of how many lines of code you're just copy-pasting from one Lambda to another, and authorization logics, database CRUD actions, cloud storage management. And now think of having all those small snippets as independent steps that you can reuse in many states machines. Fourth, it helps you error management, right? So you will be able to build fault-tolerant workflows, built-in try-catch, retry, and rollback capabilities, deal with errors and exceptions that automatically based on your defined business logic. So think of it. Nothing to maintain, no code needed, no server needed, easily monitored and empowered by 200 AWS services. I think you now need to see an example to better understand what I'm talking about. Creating a state machine is like writing a workflow diagram. Every step represents a state that inherits the input from the previous step's output. The payload in the execution of a state machine becomes the input for the first state, and the output of the last state becomes the final response of a state machine. Every step in a state machine has its own piece of logic that can be and must be as simple and reusable as possible.